who, according to you, should own the KM practice in an organization? Now, should it be the quality team? Should it be the quality team, the IT, HR, the training team, corporate communications, or should it be a separate function altogether? So, your thoughts on that?
That's a great question. It comes up in every single KM conference that I've been to.
Mm-hmm.
What should the title be of the head of knowledge management? Should it be a separate function by itself? Should it be added as part of another committee, or should it be part of another department altogether? I would say the way it came typically started in most companies, usually it is some group of mid-level or high-level managers hears about KM somehow or the other. And they say, maybe we need KM in our organization also. Then they go learn more about KM, they form a committee, eventually becomes a full-blown practice. Then the question comes, who should now own this KM initiative? And I see multiple answers to this depending on the organization's culture and how it was started, etc. So some companies have said, yes, KM should be part of everybody's work, so KM should not be a special function. It should be just part of everybody's work. So any big function can own, any big department can own KM in the organization. That's one category. Other people say, no, KM is something special. Yes, it should be embedded in everyone's work, but it's also something so unique and so precious that we must have some full-time people dedicated only to KM. And one of these should be perhaps a CKO, Chief Knowledge Officer, or Head of KM, something of that sort. Then there will be anywhere from 3 to 20 people doing full-time KM, and then dozens, maybe hundreds of people doing part-time KM. So they may have, they may be project managers and do part-time role as a knowledge project manager for that project. Or they may be people in communication and part of their role is editing knowledge objects, editing newsletters for knowledge management, etc. So there are some part-time and some full-time roles in KM. The other question is who then owns KM if it's not a full-time CKO? Should it be HR, should it be IT, as you suggested, etc. So here I'm seeing the full range of answers. In many companies, it is owned by the CIO. The Chief Information Officer, by extension, says one part of explicit knowledge management is the information assets, therefore should come under me. A more tool-centric approach would be the CTO takes over knowledge management and says, this is one of the many tools I'm rolling out, I'm going to have special tools for KM, so should come under technology. Or the core of this company is technology, our core competitive positioning is because of technology, therefore KM should come under technology. What knowledge we need to get, what knowledge we need to get through acquisition, internally, etc. is a function of what we as the technology team owns and knows. So that's one group. Other people say knowledge is something which is taught, which is learned, which is imbibed. Therefore, it should be the learning department, the HR department, etc., which takes it over. So I've seen also companies where HR owns KM. I've also seen companies where the chief learning officer also owns knowledge management. So these are sort of offshoots of the Peter Senge theory, which is companies are learning organizations. So whoever is in charge of learning should also look at what are we learning, what are we teaching in terms of knowledge, etc. Therefore, KM should come under the CLO's orbit. And the other category I'm seeing is it comes under, in some cases, marketing. So if it's a very heavily marketing-led organization, they will say knowledge is the most important for us to help us optimize our marketing, to come up with innovative marketing. Therefore, KM should be a part of marketing. And yet another category I've seen actually is in communication. Some people say knowledge activities, collaboration, knowledge work is essentially a kind of group communication. So they should be owned by the corporate communications team doing internal communication. So in some companies like ICICI Bank and one or two other companies, I've seen KM owned by the corporate communications team. So the same people who do internal branding, internal newsletters, internal posters, all that stuff, they also take over the KM function. So they teach people how to communicate, not just about HR initiatives or technology, but how to teach people about communicating, about knowledge sharing, about collaborating. So I've seen the entire end of spectrum of answers, right from full-time dedicated KM team to KM owned by a whole range of departments. So it really depends on the company's culture and on the way it evolved in the company. So if it was somebody from the CIO office who got the KM fire first, chances are he would like to perhaps keep KM with him. If it started off with the quality team, they would like to keep KM under them, and maybe have other part-time people for them also. Only if it becomes too big, or if somebody from the higher-up says, no, this is too special, we actually need to have a full-time special job only for KM, then it's spun off as a separate entity.
Interesting.
Yes.